Welcome to the class 6 students. This is the continuation part of the chapter Surfing the Wave. In my previous 3 videos, I have discussed with you the different components of the browser window, and in the last video we have talked about the navigation buttons, which are the back button, forward button, stop button, refresh button. I have shown you where these buttons are located on the browser window, on the home page of the browser window, and we have discussed the functions of those and how they help us in our search. So I hope all those things are clear to you all. Next, today I will be starting a few other components of the browser window, which are home button, search bar, bookmarks, how they are useful, how we can use them, and what the steps are to use them. So today we will be discussing all those. Okay, so let's start with today's class. So students, let's continue with today's topic. This is that same picture that I had shown you in the previous video, and this is the home page of the browser Google Chrome. Okay, so today we will be starting with home button. I hope you remember the previous topics, previous components of the window that I have explained. Now let's continue with the home button. Okay, now what is home button and where is it located? Where is it located? I can tell you, it is right here. Okay, this is the home button. This heart type shape button that you can see here is known as the home button. Okay, every time we start up the web browser, it shows a web page called the home or the start page. So we know that this whole page is the home page or the start page of this browser. Whenever we open this browser, this page will be shown. Now this home button, this small button right before the address bar, you all know that this is the address bar, right? So right situated right before the address bar, with this home button we can return to this home page whenever we want. Suppose what we are doing, suppose we have written here something and we are searching for something, and we have gone much farther deep into our search, into surfing through the web, and then we need to come back to this page again. So what will we do? Should we just close everything and then should we start up again? No, it is not required at all. Just by clicking this home button, we can come to this home page and we can start a new search as well. Okay, so every time we start up the web browser, it shows a web page called the home page or start page. Home button helps us to return to the home page. Now if I ask you in the questions, what is the significance of the home button? The home button helps us to return to the home page wherever we are within our means during our search, during us surfing the internet, wherever we are, we can return to the home page just by clicking on this home button. Okay, I hope this home button part is clear to you all. Now moving on to the next component of the browser window, which is the search bar. Now this search bar is right here in the middle. This is the search bar. What is this known as? This is known as search bar. Why is it called search bar? We can write anything, we can type anything here, and we can search it just by clicking enter. Okay, so whichever web page we are currently visiting, we do not have to leave it and start a new browser. We can just you can see here the plus sign is, that means this clicking on this plus sign will open a new tab within this browser, and new tab will also be like this, will be same to same like this, and there we can search whatever in the search bar. We can type whatever we want to know about, and by clicking enter we can get results about that topic. Okay, now this search bar is a handy search box where we can type the keywords that we are searching for and press enter and click the magnifying glass. Here, as you can see, In Google Chrome, there is no magnifying glass icon, but in other web browsers like Internet Explorer and Mozilla Firefox, there is this kind of icon. This looks almost like a magnifying glass, right? That means by writing what we want to search for and then clicking on this magnifying glass like icon, that means we are trying to, means we use the magnifying glass to search for something, right? So that means we are trying to search for that topic. Okay, the results after that, the results of our search will appear. Okay, we can even choose the search engine that we want to use by clicking on the down arrow button, which drops down a list of available search engines. So here the search engine is Google. Okay, we can have other search engines like Bing, Yahoo, or there are many more, but these Google, Bing and Yahoo are the most common one. Out of these three, Google is the commonest one. And if we want to use the other search bars, we can use those. This also depends on our choice, and this can also be changed according to our needs. Okay, so I hope home button and search bar is clear to you all. The next topic that I'm going to start is adding bookmarks. Now the next topic that we will talk about is bookmarks. Okay, now bookmark is here, exactly here. Okay, this star like sign is the sign for bookmarks, icon for adding bookmarks. Now what are these bookmarks? Suppose while reading a book we use bookmarks, we use a piece of paper, or we use something which we can use or insert inside the book to mark the page from which we can start later on, right? So for the internet, the web search also, this kind of bookmarks are required. Suppose a person is doing some research and they have to search the internet a lot. So for one day, a person might have found something and he or she wants to keep it saved, keep that page or website saved for later use, and the next day when he needs it, he wants to go to that web page or website easily without again going for that much of search. Okay, so what will that person do? That person will save that web page or website by clicking on this star shaped icon, and after clicking on this drop down list will appear. There you can change or edit the name of the website according to how you want to save it, and then you can and add the bookmarks. And what will happen later on when you want to use that web page or website again, want to open that website again, you can just click on this link only and see here is one written other bookmarks, means this list consists of lists of already added bookmarks. So whenever a person wants to go through all the already added bookmarks, that person can click on these folders to get a list of all the bookmarks that have already been added. Okay, now look into the book. If we find a web page that we like and think that we may want to come back to, we can add it to our bookmarks. These bookmarks are also called favorites. Okay, so now you know what bookmarks are, right? And how you can, means I have given you an idea how you can save bookmarks and go through bookmarks again, but there are step-by-step processes to save and search for bookmarks. We will continue that in the next video. Okay, I hope it is clear to you all.